Hey everyone, Samuel from Tech Samuel. Welcome back to the channel. We are a flutter dev diving into 2025 trend book club. Today we are tackling something game changing, like integrating AI APIs like Google ML Kit right into your Flutter app. Imagine adding smart text recognition or image analysis in minutes, no native edits. I've used this for clients to boost app UX by 40%, and you see exactly how. In the next few minutes, we'll build a live demo step by step. Hit the like button if you're ready, subscribe for more Flutter gold, and let's code some AI magic starting now. Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech with Sam YouTube channel. This is Samo, and today we'll be building a text recognition system. So this is a tutorial based, so it's focused on using Google Machine Learning Kit for text recognition. That is, a user can pick image and the machine learning will scan through the image to pick the text in the image. So this is useful if you just snap a note and you want to copy the text. Instead of writing it manually in your notepad, you can just scan the book, copy the text and put it on your notepad, as easy peasy as that. So I already have the code here, so I'll just be walking us through how to go about the code and how to make use of it. So the first thing is, we are using some packages, and the first one is Google ML Kit text recognition. So if you go to pub.dev, you can read through the documentation. There's some platform configuration setup you have to do, and the package is only available for Android and iOS. For web, another platform, you have to contact the team itself, so you can read through the documentation for better understanding. So we have the camera, because we have three functionality. You can either use the live camera to scan a particular object to get the text from it, or pick image, or use camera, whichever one. So we be using the camera package as well to have the functionality. We have the image picker and also permission handler. So these are the four packages that we'll be using in this project. So first of all, before we get into the code, there's some setup we have to do for Android and for iOS. So I'll just be working on straight. For iOS, we have our pod file. So for the pod file, if you read through the documentation for Google ML Kit, it's mentioned that you must have a minimum iOS deployment target 15.5. That's the minimum. If you create a new Flutter project, you notice that this platform iOS is commented by default and it has 12. So just uncomment it and put 16. So you can check all the integration here. By the way, the code base for this particular project is on my GitHub profile. So the link is in the description below. You can go through the repo yourself. Make sure you start and also follow me to receive update anytime I push an update, so you can use that to actually go through the code base yourself as well. So with that being said, this update also requires some permission. These are just some updated code for pod 5 for iOS, just to make use of the permission and also to resolve any error that might come in the leak. Alright, so we have the runner folder. You have to update the info plist as well. So for this, you just have to make some configuration for the permission you want to allow. You know, for iOS, you have to specify the permissions. So we have the photo library and some other permissions here. Just make sure you put this in your info plist as well. So that's all for iOS. Then for Android, just open your Android folder, go to app, then build a Gradle KTFR. You have to update your compiler SDK. If you go through the documentation for Google ML Kit for Android, you see some configuration that is required here, so you have to update it. So you have to change the compiler SDK to 35, the NDK to 27.0, and the likes. You have to update the minimum SDK, SDK, and the likes as well to make this app work. So that's all the configuration that is required, and also ProGuard for some configuration that has to do with the ML Kit. If you're having any issue whatsoever, you can join my community on Discord. The link is in the description below to ask me question or if you have anything whatsoever that you want to discuss, you can either drop it on Discord or send me an email, or also drop a report on GitHub as well. So that's all for the configuration. Then let's go straight into the code. Alright, so this is our main dot. That's basically we have our main function, and you have to have this widget filter binding to initialize your code. And also, because we are using live camera features, then we have to check all the available cameras for the phone. Because I'm using a simulator here, the live camera will not work because I can't use camera, so I will only be able to use the pick image feature to test the app how it works. So, but for you, if you want to test the live camera, you have to have this live camera to check the available cameras. Then we have our my app testing this widget as well. So going into the home screen, this is where all the functionality are. So first of all, we have a mode AM to structure the text and also the image part, because the Google ML Kit will send the data. It's just like we are submitting an image to the machine learning, so the machine learning will return the data. So the data the machine learning is returning is modeled after this particular model. So we already have the model here, so recognize results, so the result of the image that is being submitted to the Google ML Kit. So that's the model. Then we have our normal home screen, stateful widgets, then the list of camera. So when you want to pick an image, just the image picker constructor, and also just giving some variable for holding the text that we'll be getting from the ML Kit here. So make sure you dispose the text recognizer, because after picking an image, you must dispose it. So in order for, if you want to pick another image for it to get the correct one, so that's a disposer functionality. So we have request permission as well. Because we are using pick image, you have to request permission from user, and we are using live camera, so we have the permission functionality to request permission based on the functionality the user wants to use. And I've built this app in such a way that we also have the permission settings. I'll click on the app now. We have the permission settings, so you can see all the, so the users can see all the permission that is yet to be granted, and the user can open an app, open the phone setting to see to allow some permission manually. So that's that. So we have the permission. So first you are allowing camera permission, that is to use the camera. So this is the request permission. So for iOS as well, the photo status, to check the status, the current status of the permission, if the user has accepted the permission or not. So that's what this permission functionality is for. Then we have the pick image, that is for this pick image functionality. Now we are picking image from gallery, so that's the functionality to pick an image. So if the platform is iOS and the source is gallery, by default it is gallery, so it will request for permission. So once the user click on this, if the permission is not granted before, press for permission, and once user allowed, then to be able to open the user gallery, either on Android or iOS. So that's that for pick image. Then we have show permission deny dialog. In case the permission is denied, then it will show a prompt to the user just to give the user an awareness that the permission was denied. So we have that. Then on the home screen, basically we have the app bar for text recognition, and also the buttons, all these four buttons here. So it's inside a wrap widget, and a wrap widget is like column, but it breaks with widgets down once you reach the edge of the widget area. Yeah, so we have the four buttons. You can see from the first button, which is pick image, pick image, we are calling the pick image functionality that has been created up here. So pick image, for the use camera as well, we are picking image, but we are changing the image source to camera. This one we are using image gallery. And for the third one, the live camera, we are using the, if you remember, we are using the camera package. So this is a live camera so you can scan live and get the result as well. So we will soon get to this. So this is the third part. Let me add some comment to it so you can easily identify it. All right, so we have the live camera. So the live camera is just to this functionality is to request for access for the user to allow the use of their camera on the app. So once the user is granted, then it navigates. I already have a camera screen that I created. So we have the camera screen where it displays the full camera. But before we get there, let's move on. So once the user allow the permission to use his camera, then it navigates to the camera screen. So there will be a live camera. So once the user scan, then they click on capture. Once it captures the particular object, it generates the text on that particular object, and the user will be able to copy the text and use it whatsoever anyhow they want to use it. So that's that for this live camera. Then for the live permission button, it's just to check the permission that the users allowed and manually accept it. So that's that for all the buttons that we have here. All right, so for the display, recognize display area. So this is the area to check once a user either use the pick image feature and pick an image to see the result of that particular the text that was able to be picked from the image. All right, so once the user picked an image, the text that was able to be recognized from the machine learning, then it will be here. So we have another expanded widget where we check if the image is processing, it shows a circular progress indicator. If there's none, if the user is yet to pick any image, probably use pick image or use camera, then it will display no image selected. Then if none of this is true, then it will show, that means the user has picked an image already. So it will show the image file. Then from the image file, we are showing the text, recognized text as well from the image the user has picked. So that's why we have this text here. Then we get the text from Google ML Kit. So we have a button as well to copy the text to our clipboard. So we can just click a button to copy all the text and move it to wherever we want to. So I will just perform a test right now. So I'll just pick image since I can't use the live camera on a simulator. All right. All right, so you can see after picking the image, you can see the image and all the text that was able to, all the text on the image, this is it right here. So I can just click on this copy button. So the image has been copied to my clipboard, so I can go to my notepad and paste it. So that's pretty much it about this tutorial. I hope you have learned one or two. So make sure you go to click on the button in my description, the GitHub repo. And also I have the written article where I explain the nitty-gritty of the integration. So you can either read it on Medium or Hashnode or Substack, any blog website whatsoever. My articles will be there and you can play around it, clone the YouTube, the GitHub repo, and have it on your own local machine. All right. If you have learned one or two, make sure you click on the subscribe button, turn on the notification icon, and also like and drop a comment in case of any question whatsoever. Make sure you join the Discord community and also put a star to the GitHub repo if you want to. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.